more what I think when I think of violin. So let's just see what happens when I encounter a movement like this. Actually, my first thoughts are always what kind of stop list do we have here? What's the disposition of the organ? And here we see an organ with outtrack, root positive, and pedal towers. And one of the most special features, of course, is that the pedal towers are pretty far away. It's a very wide organ facade. So it already gives me some ideas for improvising. For example, do a lot of things with a pedal, not only as something in the bass, but also using beautiful solo stops. We have actually beats 16, 8, 4. We have an octave 4, so lots of possibilities to use the pedal in different ways. But of course, we start when I want to make a big partita on a hymn tune. I always start with the main stops. So let's start with the principal 8-foot. And then directly you already encounter something special in this organ, because even the principal 8 is divided. And that has to do with the fact that this organ started its life as a one-man organ, and then they decided already pretty fast to make it into a two-man organ. But that's the reason that quite some stops in the outwork are divided in bass and treble. So here we have the principal 8 of the outwork. Let's add the principal 8 and the 16-foot subas in the pedal, and also the 8-foot principal, 4-foot principal in the root positive.
Thank you.
Pennsylvania. So that's of course something that is interesting to compare. So let's listen to the Quintilena 18th in the Hauptwerk, the Quintilena 18th in the Recursive, and for the solo we use the octave forefoot in the pedal.
Thank you.
accompany it, I will use the principal 8 together with the quintilena 8 as an octave 4 in the mouth track, and the pedal 16-8-4.
Thank you.
principal 8 foot, the octave 4 foot, and the octave 2 foot.
Thank you.
in the pedal, I will use the sub-bass 16, the principal 8, the octave 4, and the trumpet 8. and a rush print of the bell. Principal four and the Vox Humana era. Thank you.